Trias and CKB Nervos Network have been following textbook Elliott wave patterns as projected in advance. Remembering we only do probabilities and never certainties, but these things often play out. So today we're going to do an update, not only on these coins, but the principles, the core principles of mass psychology of buying and selling that applies to all crypto. If you like today's video, like, subscribe, hit the bell notification. If you don't know me by now, my name is Jiggy. I'm the award-winning author of The Extraordinary New Venture Capital Opportunity, How to Invest Like a Pro, been featured in the best-selling book, High Probability Trading Strategies, back in 2008. I used to focus on currencies alone, but now exclusive on cryptocurrency. So let's dive straight in. So many of you know, in my former life as a math teacher, I used to be known as the Breakdancing Math Teacher. A bit of fun before we get started is, can you guess what move is going to come next? I know you've been appreciating my dancing, so I'm going to share a bit more with you. But what move is going to come next? All right, let's have a look at the beginning, and then we're going to see at the end of today's video what move came. What move's going to be finished on, right? What's going to be finished on and what's coming next? Or what's at the end? What do you think is going to be at the end? We'll dive back in at the end of today's video. So we want to have a quick loop back on Trias, first of all. We did a video on September 17th. And what I said in that video, if I can just bring up a laser so I can show this to you clearly, is we look like we're forming this kind of ABC correction, and we should expect this upside movement of a five-wave sequence. And look, there's no guarantees in this game, but we can look at pattern recognition and what's likely to happen with high probability. What happened next? Bang. Textbook. Look at this. This was the bit, this was the correction that we were referring to down here, right down here. And then this movement happened as projected. Yeah, actually, we was anticipating here, it went a bit overextended. That's going to give us valuable information on what's likely to occur next. Because I know you've been asking for an update with Trias. So today we're going to get a full update with Trias. And then, you know, we did another video. It was on the 31st of August. And we said we should be anticipating some type of correction after a five-wave sequence. We normally get a correction. This type of correction, movement to the downside. And again, what happened with Trias? We got this big movement to the downside, right? Yeah, it's not a textbook ABC. It's not as clean, but we're going to look into that in a second as well. And then we did CKB, right? A last CKB video, Nervos Network. I know you taught me how to pronounce it properly now. Nervos. 8th of October. And we said a similar thing. You know, we had this correction down here, wave two, and we should anticipate this bullish movement. I think, what was the title of the video? Nervos Network, ready to do another 400% surge. How is CKB likely to play out? And we just said this, right? We did a detailed video, and we said this was the price action likely to play out at around 4 cents thereabouts. And what has CKB done? We're going to dive into a bit more detail. It's like bang on, right? Bang on. I don't even think it's finished yet, but it's done this massive move to the upside. Boom. This nice move to the upside as anticipated. Again, never certainties, but only probabilities, but often they play out like this. So we're going to start with Trias. We're going to start with Trias. I'm going to go onto the charts. Let's get rid of this. So if you want to learn how to do this for yourself, because I can't cover all the coins, right? I read all your comments, and I only do one video a day. So if you want to learn how to do this for yourself so you can read the psychology of the markets, when's the optimal time to buy, to sell, take my free Elliott Wave and Fibonacci Masterclass. I created it for you. I've simplified these complex analysis patterns, but you can see them. And when you see them, you can take valuable information. So Trias, let's have a look. Trias. So, and by the way, I haven't invested in Trias or CKB. I've only been covering these coins because you've asked me to, right? Because you've been invested in them. And when we first did the video, we saw this correction. We said this is likely to be the end of a correction and get a reversal. We did. We got that movement. And at this stage, we weren't sure if it's going to finish as an A, B, C, and then continue as a deeper correction, or if this was going to end up being a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 wave sequence and a continuation of the trend and breaking all-time new highs. So we only can go with probabilities, never certainties. You know, you're going to hear me say that a million times because I read your comments and I read the The FOMO is real. The fear of missing out, the fear, uncertainty, and doubt is real. So we can only go by the information at hand and make objective business decisions. So we're going to jump into the weekly chart first of all, right? Let's forget the price action for a second. I'm going to double click on the indicator, right? The indicator has been working really, really well for us. Now, what we can see is the blue line is deeply oversold, meaning it's below this black line, and the red line is also coming here. So that means the downward movement should be coming close to an end. So we should expect a reversal at some point over the next 1 or 2 weeks, right? And when this bullish reversal occurs, that should coincide with pattern and price. So today we're going to focus on pattern and price with the daily chart, right? So let's just start with pattern first of all. So at the time of the last video, we weren't sure if it was going to be an ABC or a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 sequence. So what it looks like now, I'm going to show you a trick, right? This trick, well, it's not really a trick, it's just intelligence, right? But you have to see it, right? So now we're saying this looks like a wave one, an ABC of a wave two. That's what we said before. And we weren't sure if this was going to be an ABC or a 1, 2, 3. Now I'm now more convinced it's more of a 3, and we're forming what looks like some type of wave 4, and then we should anticipate a wave 5. And let me tell you my thinking. The reason is the weekly momentum. We know that's coming towards, it's oversold. So it looks like it's making a bullish reversal. But wave C's, because you can do it by a process of elimination. Wave C's are more often than not 100% of wave A. And as a maximum, typical maximum is 1.618. So that means wave, if this was a wave A and it was a correction, this here should be a maximum more often than not at this red line and the extreme maximum here. But we see we shot past that like it wasn't even there. I mean, it had a bit of resistance by over here. So now this makes it more highly probable that this is a wave 3 and not a C, because it's closer to the what's called the 2.618. Now, I know I'll throw these terms around, you know, the numbers and everything else and Fibonacci ratios. You might be used to it or you might not, but take my free Elliott Wave and Fibonacci Masterclass, because I break down the thinking, because these patterns unfold. And even though we're covering Trias and CKB today, it applies to all crypto. And 60, 70% of the time, these patterns are really, really clear. Even with low caps, you see it with cross wallet, with cross swap, with even some of the launch pads, you'll see the price, the action, the psychology of buying and selling just plays out. So you can see here, look at this, 2.618. Yeah, this is more common than an extreme for a wave 3. So we got more reason to believe it's a wave 3. A wave 3, we're forming what looks like a deep wave 4, and we should anticipate a wave 5. So now let's just get rid of this line. Let's get rid of these lines, so we just have the numbers. Now I just want to see, what is a typical wave 4? So first of all, Elliott wave rules. If you take my masterclass, I cover this rule, which is wave 4. If this is a wave 4, it should not trade into a range of wave 1. If it does, it invalidates the wave count and we need to reevaluate. That's why it's probabilities, never certainties, right? So we have to make business decisions based on the information at hand. And right now, it has not traded into this range. Most common for a wave 4 correction, if we measure the wave beginning of wave 3 to the end of wave 3, a typical minimum wave 4 correction is 38.2, 50%, and a maximum is 62%. And we can see we're at that maximum range. Right, we've got to add that maximum range. And then we're going to do one more, which is an external retracement of what looks like, because this looks like to me, I actually jumped into an hourly chart earlier just to have a quick look. I'm just going to jump into an hourly chart, because sometimes the wave structure is cleaner or clearer on a lower time frame. So this looks like, you know, we can do a couple of counts, but this looks like a nice movement to the downside. We've got this ABC correction over here, and we've got another movement to the downside. Right, that's what we've got. And we're using intermediate wave counts here. So now we're going to jump back into the daily chart. And you can see these arrows are drawn here. Right. So what we can do, because we're now doing an intermediate wave count, we can use candlesticks. This just gives us a bit more valuable information. You'll see the ranges are a bit more extreme. And it gives us a clearer picture. And this is important. Again, it takes practice, but you know, you can lean on me for this at the moment. So what we're going to do now is measure what looks like. Let me just draw this out for you. What looks like a nice A, B, let's have a look. Come on, let's go. There we go. It looks like a wave A, B, and what looks like it's forming, it might even have completed a wave C, right? Of a four, right? It's not confirmed, but it's in that zone. It's in that price zone and the pattern zone as well. And it, again, we came to this extreme down here. So what I wanted to quickly do was measure this wave A, project it from this wave B, and 62% tends to be the minimum. You see that? It's tagged that range over here. And then we're just going to do an external retracement, which is this low to this high of this wave B. And I know I'm covering it fast, but this is important information. Again, with practice, everything is difficult before it's easy. But with practice, this becomes much more second nature. So this one's irrelevant. It's the 1.2. So basically what I'm showing you here is this looks like a potential wave 4 low. Potential. What would confirm it? Well, we're into the previous swing high range, but really what will confirm it is a break and a close above this line here, which is the close. So Trias, let's just wrap up with Trias, is what we're saying here. Looks like we should form, again, we're taking the weekly indicator into account. You know, it's deeply oversold, right? We know that information now. And then on the daily, we're going to pull up the indicator as well. I'm going to pull up the 13. There's a particular setting, just a bit cleaner. Let's just see. Let's just even look at the 21. Because sometimes when they're a bit choppy, it's a bit harder to see. Yeah, they're all a bit choppy. So the 13, let me just see what the 8 looks like. So what we're looking for is the indicator that cleanly marries up with these, especially the major lows. Yeah, it looks like the 13 might be our best bet here. 13. Yeah, 13 does a decent job. Because the trouble with indicators is you're trying to get the one that marries up the most, but it's also timely on point as well. So this one actually marries up okay, but it's a bit slow. I'm just going to look at the 34 as well. Okay, this one's probably the cleanest, right? You can see the major highs and the lows. So this one might give us the most valuable information because this low, this wave two low, was married up nicely down here. So this wave two low, if I can draw it here, this wave two low married up with this indicator down here. I don't know if you can actually see it. It's like this, right? So we might actually stick with this. Yeah, it just gives us valuable information. And what it just tells us is the next bullish reversal should coincide with the weekly bullish reversal. And then we should anticipate sideways to up with a wave five. So let's just finish up with Trias on a wave five price projection. If this does hold, if it doesn't trade into this wave one range, if it doesn't trade into this range and it holds down here and it makes a high above this swing high and this swing high, the price projection for Trias, a typical price projection. So we're going to make one assumption. We're going to make the assumption that this is the wave four low. And it can go lower and it might not end up being a wave four. So that's important to know. Probabilities, never certainties. But let's just assume for a price projection that this is the wave four low. So what we do, typical wave five, is we measure wave one to wave three, project it from a wave four. Let's go to the extreme of wave four. And a typical wave five, minimum 62%, 100% is the two major price zones. And we expect it to go above the extreme of the wave three. Hopefully that's making sense. Again, if this is new to you, you know, take my free Elliott Wave Fibonacci Masterclass, because even just watching my videos and having taken the Masterclass, you'll just get a bit more context and you'll see how these things pan out time and time and time again. So what are the two price targets for Trias? The typical price targets is 26 cents to around 35, 36 cents thereabouts. And today's price is around 10 cents, right? 10 cents. Now, what I've also noticed, and keep this in mind, is crypto, is this is not typical in other markets, but for a wave five, often it overextends. And a lot of the time, it's overextending to 1.618. So don't be overly surprised if we get into the typical range of a wave five, exceed this high, but then sometimes it just gets this extreme bullish behavior. And that's kind of what we saw with Trias earlier this year. Was it earlier this year? Yeah, it was earlier this year. It just went parabolic, right? These were typical zones. And then the last wave, it just like panic buying. It's like, it's crazy, unsustainable panic buying. And because we've got that in the history of Trias, don't be overly surprised if this is going to occur again, but on a bigger scale. Typical buying, typical maximum wave three. And then don't be overly surprised if it overextends, if it does, right? It's always an if. And just hopefully you guys have been risk-free on this now, because we covered this down here originally And it's been just following pretty much textbook, but patience has been a big, big thing with Trias. All right, that's Trias. So now we're going to jump into Nervos Network. Nervos Network. So a quick reminder, last video, like we said at the beginning, it's on the 8th of October. We was anticipating this wave too low and these high price projections. And we was anticipating this, right, ahead of time. Leading indicators, so, so important. And if you want to learn how to do this, take my free Elliott Fibonacci Masterclass. It's I've spent a lot of time trying to simplify it for you. So Nervos Network, we're going to jump into our live chart. Let's see if it opens up for me. All right. Let's see. It's been a bit slow. All right, here we go. Bang. All right, let's get rid of all these lines, right? Let's get rid of these now. All right, because what we can see is... In the last video, we had this blue arrow saying sideways to up, anticipated in these two green zones. And like clockwork, like magic almost, it just hit them. Even with the time, actually. Let's pull up at the time. Look at that. It went right into the maximum time zone. So we look like we're coming towards a typical wave three zone. So today, we're going to now do an update on Nervos Network. Let's just get rid of this. We can get rid of these as well. Now that we've also gone above the extreme. Now that we've gone above this wave one extreme with this price, this wave two is now confirmed. So we can actually get rid of the question mark. So now we know that's all good. This goes over here. We can say, no, it didn't turn into a complex correction. It was actually a very simple A, B, C on a microwave count. Let's just quickly update this. Boom. All right, so now what we're going to focus on is this part of the market here, right? What does this look like to us? What does it look like, right? Keep it in mind that we, the Nervos Network did this complex correction, but it was just so beautiful. It was quite neat for a complex correction. We pegged this low. If you look at the previous videos I did on Nervos, and then we was anticipating this, we anticipate a wave two correction, and we anticipated this. So this is what we want to look at. So I'm just going to start this line again. I'm just going to go over here. Let's just do it like this. The main thing to keep into account is a typical wave three zone is if we measure wave, I'm going to show you like this actually. We're going to measure the beginning of wave one to the top of wave one and project it forward from the beginning of wave or the end of wave two, which is the beginning of wave three. And we're going to do some price projections. And what's most common and very, very powerful with Fibonacci, which is the psychology, just measuring the psychology of buying and selling. The two ratios most common is 1.618 is the typical wave three price zone and 2.618 is the extended. But what we want to look at is, do we see any form of sub-degree wave count in this wave count? So we can clearly see right now, as of this moment in time, live, we are very clearly at this 1.618. So we want to know, is this going to hold as a big resistance and we're going to get a wave four correction? So let's look at the clues. We're going to jump into the top left. We're going to go to the weekly. Okay, the weekly momentum is bearish, right? Okay, clue number one is bearish. Momentum is moving down, price is moving up. That's what you call divergence. Okay, so that's clue number one. And then clue number two, let's have a look at the momentum on this chart. All right, let me just get clean this up. All right, so we've got a bearish reversal. These highs have been marrying up quite nicely with this particular indicator, which is quite nice for us. So what we're going to look at now is, what I want to see is, you know, is this a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of a wave three? And I sometimes like jumping into a lower time frame, like a 4-hour chart, just to see if it's cleaner and clearer. Yeah, look, it looks quite clean in terms of this being, you know, the wave one is not as clean, but the wave three, this looks like a wave three, four, and we're forming a final leg of a wave five. So my wave count on this, and again, you just have to make decisions, but with the training, most people come up with pretty much the same decision or same answer, which it looks like. You know, a nice wave one, a wave two, a wave three, an ABC of a wave four, and it looks like we're forming the final leg of a wave five. And we're doing this as an intermediate count, bang. Hopefully that's clear. Let me just draw the lines for a second so you can see it. That's what we're looking at here as a potential 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And what we want to do now is use this intermediate wave count and this macro wave count. So let me just make sure that's clear. I cover this in the masterclass and I cover it in some of my detailed courses. And if you buy one of my courses, you actually get invited to my private Telegram where you get exclusive premier access to YouTube content, and we do some other bonuses as well. So this is the macro price target of a wave three. And now we're going to do a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, an intermediate price target of a wave three. And now when we get a cluster, that tends to be very powerful for us. So now let's just do it very simply. There's two particular ones we're going to measure. This wave one, I'm not going to go into too much detail now. I'm just going to do it. Kind of get to the crunch. Measure wave 1 to 3, project it from this potential wave four. It looks like a wave four. And the two that we want is 62.8. 38 is another important one, and 100. Yeah, but it's more often it's 62. But we want to be aware of 38, right? I'm going to put the 38 in here because it seems to be really relevant. The 100 seems to be way out, so we don't even need it, right? So we've got this cluster over here. And then we're going to use something called a Fibonacci external retracement. We're going to measure wave four. And wave five and wave four have a direct relationship. And the two most common typical numbers is 1.272 to 1.618, right? And you can see we've got this cluster, right? So we've got these two zones over here. We've got this zone down here. And we've got this slightly more extreme zone up here, right? So now what we're going to finish on is this. We are going to look. This is beautiful. Now we're going to go into a micro wave count, 3 degrees of wave count. Go watch it. Yeah. Okay, this is like a mini masterclass in itself, right? But it's important for you to know, man, because sometimes this can be so valuable to give you peace of mind, to, you know, because people might be kind of looking at, if you did buy down here and the price is moving up, like, where do I sell? Well, now we know the price targets is likely to have an end of a wave three. So you can kind of go, right, want to get risk-free, take some good profits, and then let the market correct. That's just natural. And wave four tends to be a profit-taking wave. So macro wave counts, right, is this. Wave one, wave two, wave three, right? Macro. Intermediate wave count is looking at the wave three in itself, but the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of a wave three. Now the micro wave count is going to focus on just the wave five of the wave three, which will break down what looks like really clearly 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of a five of a three, right? So we've got 3 degrees count. I know I did that quite fast, so don't worry if that went a bit over your head. But we want to focus on this part here now, right? Because when you've got 3 degrees of wave counts, that gives us really, really highly probable information. So what we want to do with the, especially with the micro counts, is use candles, because we want the extremes to go, oh my God, look at this. Look at that. That's a real outlier, isn't it? 1, 2, 3, 4. Jeez, look at that. I might even need to jump into a, let me just have a look. Yeah, I reckon I'm going to need to jump into, let's have a look. Let me just do a couple of things. Let me just do, it's a wide bar, man. It's a wide bar. Let's have a look. Just want to see what levels that bar hit. Oh, nice, nice. So it did hit 1.618. Okay, cool, cool, cool. Okay, okay. So what this looks like then to me then is a couple of things. Again, this is the business of trading. Welcome to the business of technical analysis, where we can only do probabilities and never certainties, you know, because what it looks like now, going into the micro count, what it looks like to me is this here, it looks like a wave one, a wave two. This actually looks like a wave three because it hit a 1.618. It's forming some type of wave four, and we should anticipate one final leg up. Now, the one final leg up actually is pretty reasonable that we can expect it to hit the extreme of the wave three, right? The extreme on the macro was 2.618, but the 100% extreme is also there. So now what we're going to do is, we don't have the information that the wave four is complete. We don't have that right now. We're just going to have to assume, just for this exercise, that this is the wave four low, right? It might come a bit lower before it makes another high, if it does that. But what we know, what we do know, is that the daily momentum is bearish, right? So it should be sideways to down for a few days. That should complete the wave four. And then we should anticipate the wave five to coincide with this wave five on the micro count, and the next bearish reversal may coincide with the wave five of wave five of a wave three of CKB to do a wave four reversal. That's just the probability. So let's wrap up on the micro Fibonacci ratios, right? So what we're going to do is just something very, very simple. We're going to measure the beginning of wave 1 on this macro count, the top of wave 3, and project it forward from what is this possible wave 4. Two numbers that we want is 62 to 100. Bless me. Excuse me. I sensed that coming, but there you go. So now we've got these two ranges. We've got this one over here. I'm doing it in detail and deliberate because I want you to know the method behind the madness, right? And we've got this one over here, which is in this cluster. That makes it very, very highly probable. And then we're going to do an external retracement, wave 3 to the wave 4. And again, the wave 4 is not confirmed, but we're just going with the information that's likely. And then again, we've got these two clusters. So now we've got these two top price zones, which is up here and here. Are the two highly probable zones, and it will probably coincide with the next daily bearish reversal. So there you have it. There you have it. So what do we anticipate for CKB Nervos Network? Let's wrap this up. Let's wrap it up, and then we'll see what is that move at the end of the show. Is what we now see is we're probably going to get what we're looking like we've got already, this final leg. And it looks like it'll probably complete here, here, or the extreme of here. We don't know yet. Because what you want to do when you're taking profits, especially if you've got stop loss features, if you're on a centralized exchange, which I'm not even sure if it is where is Nervos Network? Let's have a quick look. CKB. You know, I mainly use most of my stuff I'm doing on decentralized exchanges. CKB, where is CKB? Oh, Nervos, there we go. Which doesn't have stop losses. It's kind of like a new thing that's being built, decentralized. Oh, yeah, it's on Binance, right? So, yeah, if you've got this on Binance, you can use stop losses and trail your stop losses, everything else. So, oh, yeah, it's just really, you know, it's on a lot of exchanges. What's the market cap of this? Like nearly a billion. Awesome. It's 114, so it's really looking really, really healthy. You know, what's the volume? 50 million. Volume 5%. Okay. You know, I just thought I'd just check this. So if you got this on Binance, you can use a stop loss, right? So the trick is this. We don't know. Nobody knows, right? Is the market going to top out where it is and then go for a wave 4 correction? Yeah, into a nice wave 4 correction. Or is it going to really overextend? And sometimes, for whatever reason, it just really overextends. So when you've got the feature, what you can do is you can do something called move your stop loss to swing lows. I covered this before, but I don't know if it made sense to a lot of people. So what you do is... Let's just do this because I think this is powerful. I'm just going to cover it with you. Let's just say the market was here. I'm just going to take the data back a bit. And let's just say the market moved like this. And let's say we didn't know where the market was going to end. The logical place to put your stop loss is this. Initially, it would be this swing low. And then you would have moved it up to this swing low, right? And then as the market moves and it made a new high, made a new low, and then it made a new high again, again, it's up to you. Depends on how conservative. But when you're coming towards an end of a price zone, really highly probable price zone, move your stop loss to the next swing low, right? Or you can have a certain set of rules on the next bullish reversal, move it to the next swing low. And then what will tend to happen is that the market will move up. It might have another little swing down, and then it moves up again. And what you simply do, if you're looking to maximize your profit, is you literally just move your stop loss to there now, right? And then eventually you're just like capturing more and more of the market. Because sometimes what will happen, and you know, it'll happen maybe 5, 10, 15% of the time, this will happen, and then maybe a bit, and you just then trail your stop on a one day low. Literally, like you just literally keep trailing it. And then if and when the reversal happens, you will get stopped out at this point over here. You will capture all this extra price action, right? So it's important to know, even though we've got this high probability price zones, you know, it doesn't matter. Anything can happen, but we can only go with the probabilities of what's likely to happen. So there you go. That was pretty detailed. We did Trias and we did CKB. So let's just zoom out and let me just kind of summarize. So we've got a nice clean picture over here. Let me now delete these. Let's get rid of these. Get rid of this. Oh, come on. Okay. There we go. So move that there. Let me just get rid of this. Just want to give a nice clean snapshot so you have a clear picture so we can have a nice summary of this as well. Is, I know we've got a few, quite a few different lines over here, but what looks clear to me is we should anticipate this wave three into this zone. And then we're going to anticipate a wave four. And we don't need to cover that in detail right now, because if it hasn't occurred yet, we don't need to get overly anal about it. But what we'll do is we'll just finish this video with a wave three with a question mark, saying we're anticipating this to be a wave three. Yeah. Hopefully that makes sense, right? So like, subscribe, hit the bell notification. If you want to learn how to do this for yourself, I've created a free Elliott Wave and Fibonacci Masterclass. Most people don't know about this. It's crazy to me. I just like, it allows me to see things that people don't see normally. And it will allow you to see things that people don't see normally. It will give you an edge so you can maximize your profits, because people are terrible, terrible at taking profits. So this will just really, really help. So let's finish on. All right, here we go. I'm going to have to forward it. So this was the video that I created for my math students when I was first beginning to teach. All right, let's see. Let me make sure the volume's on max. Volume's on max. All right, so max. All right, let's go. All right, let's see what move I finish on. Did you make a guess? What's the final move of this mini little set? This was a show that we did in Nottingham. Let's do a full screen. Let's see how clear it is. Let's go for it. The more space I get, the better I write. Oh, never this I write. One. But if ever I write, I need the space to say whatever I like. Now just change clothes and go. Now I stay fresh to death, aborted from the projects. And I'm going to take you to the top of the globe. Let's go. Let's exchange clothes and go. And girl, I promise you, no substitutes. Just me. And I ain't gonna tell you again. Let's get ghosts in the phantom. You can bring your friend, we can make this a tandem. Or you can come by yourself and you can stand them. Best believe I. Alright, so the answer was, it was a headstand. It was a headstand freeze. Just a headstand freeze. There weren't nothing too special about it. The finishing move was, it was that. I actually did something else at the end of it, but this video cut and it went to the next section. So there you have it. So today we covered Trias. Trias is following textbook Elliott Wave and Fibonacci. CKB Nervos Network is also doing the same. It's an update, but it applies to all crypto. And 60-70% of the time, these patterns are really, really clear and really, really evident. So take my free Elliott Wave and Fibonacci Masterclass. I'm telling you, it allows you, like even with Bitcoin, Bitcoin's doing textbook patterns. If you see my last video, it was all about Elliott Wave and Fibonacci, momentum indicators, and it gives us clues what's likely to happen with high probability next. So you can have peace of mind to see what is likely to happen. And with all your cryptocurrency, you can manage your portfolio better, again, with more objective decision making. So today we're going to finish with a quote. Normally I go with my book, but I'm going to do one off the top of my head today. Well, I was thinking about it earlier. There was two, but I want to focus on one. The one that I want to focus on is from a book called Black Box Thinking. It's beneath every success is a mountain of necessary failure. Beneath every success is a mountain of necessary failure. So we don't fail on purpose, but we know and need to know that it's possible. That's okay, because the biggest learnings don't come from successes, funny enough. They come from making mistakes. They come from errors. They come from, you know, you don't want to make error over and over again, but we learn fast from those. So some of the most successful people on the planet in all aspects of life, and people don't often see this because they only see their successes, they have failed the most, and that is why they succeed. So it's okay to not understand something, because you can read an article, you can watch a YouTube video, bang, you now understand it. You can, you know, maybe you haven't managed your position correctly, and in hindsight, you think, I should have known that it was a 1.618 wave three, I should have taken my profits, but for some reason you didn't, and then it did do a correction. But for the next one, you now know how these markets operate. So it's keep learning. Failure is a part of the journey. Taking a loss in crypto or in any investment is part of the cost of doing business. So just know that's normal. It's natural. Fear and greed is real. That's why you want to have a written plan. So you can be objective, mechanical, and you don't have to do much emotional thinking. So like, subscribe, hit the bell notification. I appreciate you. Take my free Elliott Fibonacci Masterclass. I'm telling you, it's good. You know, I put a lot of work and effort into it. But you can purchase my course, which is still running at a discount. And the course itself breaks everything down to 5-minute bite-sized chunks. So you just go to the foundation level, the real core basics, the intermediate level, and the advanced on Elliott waves. And then we do the same for Fibonacci, you know, basic retracements, going to external retracements, and then Fibonacci extensions, wave extension, the relationship that the waves have. And there's a few bonuses in the course as well. All right. Have a great day. Have a great week. And I'll see you soon.